So we need to work within the file system when we're writing our Python code. Said this comes up a lot when we're working with files. Maybe we need to check what directory we're in. We want to get a list of the files in that directory and so on. So we're going to use the pathlib in the path library, not os.path. os.path was something we used to do with older versions of Python, but with Python 3.6, we now have a cleaner and slightly faster method for checking and talking to the file system to see what's going on. So what I've got here in my code is you'll see I've imported from the path library pathlib, I've imported path from pathlib, the other way around. And one of the most common things we want to do is just say, what directory am I in now? Because I may need that to build a file path or simply to check some information. So CWD will return the current working directory, and we'll print that out on the screen so you can see that. And then you can also, I love this little feature. It's such a simple thing, but it allows you to build a full path name. So, because I'm always mixing up forward slash and backslash, and I can never remember when I'm building a path, is it a backslash or a forward slash, and depends what systems you're on. And so I love the fact I can just use a method called joinPath, and I give it the directory name, and I give it the file name, and it inserts the right slash for me. So I don't have to remember backslash or forward slash. This makes me happy. It's the little things in life. You know, you have to appreciate them. So this will simply insert the appropriate slash for me between the file path, the directory name, and the file name itself. And I'll just print that on the screen so you can see how that appears. And another useful tool is the ability to check and see if a file exists. This comes up a lot of times when we're writing code that's maybe going to be moving a file from one place to another, or before we write code that's going to read a file, it's a really good practice to just check and see if the file exists first, rather than trying to call an open and having the open command fail. It's much cleaner to say, hey, is the file there? If it is, great, let's open it and continue so that you have more controlled flow and cleaner error handling. So it's just a nicer way to handle things than writing a bunch of try-catch statements. So if we run this code here, we go down here and execute it. What you're going to see on the screen is you're going to, and I'm just going to make this a little bigger so you can see it a little better. And what you're going to see is, here's that current working directory. Yes, I have a very long set of subdirectories that I use when I'm storing my demo files to keep track of everything. And then you can see the full path, and you can see it's here's the full file directory name and the appropriate slash added to that directory. And does that file exist? Well, no, I was just inventing and pretending there was a file called new file. It doesn't actually exist in this directory. If it did, you'd see it listed over here in my list of files. So it says false. So some neat operations we can do for manipulating the different paths. Now, the other thing we often need to do is navigate between different directories, see what files are in a directory and things like that. So let's see how we can do that using the same awesome library. So again, I'm probably going to start with just my current working directory because you can actually see the files that I have here, so it'll be easier for you to see it's working correctly. I can actually test to see if I'm past something, whether that value is points to a directory or a file, which can be useful as well. So if you know you should be looking at a directory, you can check that first. Or if you know you should be opening a file, you can check to make sure it is a file. And again, you can list the directory contents. So if I run this code here, what we're going to see, start with a nice clean screen, is, so again, I'm just going to bring this up a bit so it's a little easier for you to see what's happening. Especially with a list of file names, it gets a little bit long. So what you can see is the current working directory. Is this a directory? Yes, because I asked it, is the current working directory a directory? It is. Is it a file? No, so it returns false. And if you go in, you see a list of all the files that I currently have inside that particular directory. So again, this is really handy because sometimes you might need to read all the files in a particular directory. So this way you can sort of get a list of the files. And you can use the is file or is directory to see if that, when it returns a value. So let's say you have two subfolders and six files. You only want to open the files. You may not want to open the subfolders. So this way you can use that is directory to know, hey, that what I found in this directory, was it a directory value, like a subdirectory I need to move into, or is it a file that I should be opening? So these two things together give us a lot of power for navigating across folder structures and opening all the files in a particular folder and so on. And the last one I want to show you here is from the options we have for just looking up information about a file. In the next module, we're going to talk about how to read and write to files, so don't worry about that yet. So if I have a location, and I want to know information about the file. So a lot of times we end up writing code that has to move maybe a file from one place to another, or we have a file that has data in it, which we're going to be using to do some data science or to load into a database. And we may want to make sure that that file, it has data in it. I actually ran into a genuine live issue where I was loading a data file into a database, and I accidentally deleted all my code, basically said, delete the records that are currently there, take the data file, load that data file into the table to replace the data. And something had gone wrong with the file transfer, so I deleted all the records in the table and then loaded an empty file. So when I was done, there were no records in the database table. So things like being able to check the size of the file and stuff before you load it can be really useful to notice things and do good logging to explain why something's working or might have failed, to help people figure out when they come back afterwards, hey, why did our data load fail? These kinds of commands allow you to check things along the way and help you debug what might have gone wrong when later on there's no data in that table. So if we look at the code here, I can do things like create a path to that name. So I get the working directory. I get the file name by joining the path to the file name itself. And then I can request, like, what's the file's name? What's the file suffix? .txt, .csv? What folder is it in? And statistics about it, like its size or when was it last modified and so on. So if I run this code, what you're going to see here is you're going to see that the file name is demo.txt, and that was the file we were pointing to here, demo.txt. The suffix is .txt. It's in the folder 06 file system, and the size is 11 kilobytes. So anytime you're writing code that's going to be reading files or writing to files, before you open up that file, take a look at some of these to check things first and make sure that everything's the way it should be before you start modifying those files. And on which note, maybe that's what we should look at next.